So hey guys, we're here with Matt today and he's going to explain to us what a test jig is. So Matt, can you explain to the audience what a test jig is and why do we need it?
We need a test jig. But to help me explain why we need a test jig, I'm going to give a little bit of context into the manufacturing process.
Okay.
So we've got a specification of what we need from the keyboard. So that's written down. And then we've made an electronic circuit that we think is going to satisfy the specification, and through iterations and testing, we get it right. And then we turn that into a circuit board, and then that is sent to the factory, and the factory ends up making a circuit board. So this is, for example, the left-hand side of an older version. So that gets sent from the PCB factory to the PCBA factory. So PCBA stands for printed circuit board assembly, the ASE assembly. And they take all the components, for example, this is one that I've assembled by hand, but in the factory what would happen is a machine would spread solder paste on all the exposed metal, and then a robot would place all the components on really quickly. And that would go on a conveyor belt through an oven, melt the solder, and then everything's soldered on. And at that point, it should be working, it should be functional as we need. And then they get taken to the factory that is going to be doing the assembly. So what happens there is they'll take the circuit boards and they'll put them inside the metal case, and they'll screw everything together and they'll put all the keys on, and then there'll be like a final test where they press all the keys and check all the LEDs. Now if at that point something is wrong or broken with the circuit board, we'll only discover then. So after all, they've done all this work and they've used up all the material, they've made this keyboard pair that no longer works, and we'll have to put that to one side and work out why it won't work later. The earlier that you can spot a problem in the manufacturing process, the better. So there's actually a lot of tests that happen. So after they make the circuit board, they use a machine that checks all of the nets. So it uses like little needles that come down and checks all these positions, and it happens super, super quick, and it validates that all the connections that you specify in the design files are connected on the circuit board. And if any fail, you throw them away then. If they're passing, then they go into the robot that does the assembly. So then all the pieces get placed and soldered, and then we get a bare board like this before it goes into the keyboard. And then what we use is a test jig to test the functionality then. So that's why we need a test jig, to test all the functionality as early as we can in the process. In the Hubble, the microchip that we're using is 3.3 volts. The USB is 5 volts. So one of the things in the specification is to check that the 3.3 volt regulator is working correctly. So what we have is on this circuit board, I don't know if you can see, this is the front side. Normally you put all the test points on the back side of the board so that after it's been assembled, you put it into a jig that has lots of these pogo pins. So these are gold-plated, springy pins. This gets soldered down here, and then this top part is springy. So this goes in like this, and you have one pin that lines up with each of these little spots here. So you can, if the camera's focusing, you can see one here is 5 volts and one is 3.3 volts. Uh-huh. So I've made a little pad that connects to the output of the 3.3 volt regulator. This is the circuit board. There's a A to D converter, which stands for analog to digital converter, and it can measure voltages. And one of the wires comes to this header. There'll be a bunch of wire that comes out. One of the wires will be connected to this pogo pin. When the Hubble comes down, that will get pushed on here. Then on here, we can turn on the 5 volts and then measure the 3.3 volts. And then if the 3.3 volts is more than 3.25 volts and less than 3.35 volts, for example, then that test has passed. So this isn't our test jig because we haven't built it yet, but it will look something like this. There'll be a circuit board underneath with all the gold pogo pins that we saw earlier. Then our circuit board will be on the top, and it gets pushed down by these feet here so that it's pressed up against all of these pogo pins. And then the test fixture board that I was explaining earlier will drive all of these pins and read the signals from them to validate all the features that we need to test. And then for all of these tests, all the ones where I've worked out that we can do an automatic test, all the ones with a 1 in this column, we test them all automatically, all as quickly as possible, and only if you get, on the test jig, we've got a couple of LEDs here. So one light will come on and flash when it's doing the testing, and the other light will either be a red or a green at the end. So if it's a green, everything's good, it gets sent to the factory, they do the assembly, and the electronics is fine. If it's a red, then it gets taken out, and we try and fix it before we do the assembly.
Cool. Thanks, Matt.
No problem.
If you're interested to learn more about the Race keyboard, you can click the subscribe button. Or if you're interested to purchase one of these beauties, you can head over to our website at dygma.com.